My name is Stanford Schor. I work currently at Stanford University in the Einav Lab, and I am a first-year student pursuing an MD-PhD. So I grew up in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. My parents are both university professors, so I grew up in a relatively nice area in the inner city. But my parents were very adamant that I go to public school, even though I didn't always view it potentially as a career option. Science was always there as just like a fact of my life. My project is essentially I'm mapping out the interaction between the hepatitis C virus proteome and a library of 150 actin dynamics proteins. So I'm looking at these to see how hepatitis C co-opts host mechanisms in order to prolong infection. So hepatitis C is part of a family of viruses called flaviviridae, and that includes West Nile, dengue, and yellow fever, all of which have high morbidity and mortality in humans. And so what I'd like to see is that the sorts of interactions that I find in hepatitis C can be translated into potential treatments for these other dangerous viruses. I'm in a relatively small lab that has very much a family feel to it, kind of being here in, I guess, the beginning days of this lab.
Where's your protective gear?
Where's my protective gear? It's okay, it's just cancer cells, so it's not gonna hurt. What hurts you makes you stronger, right?
I don't know if that quite works in science.
The greatest benefit of this lab is that basically everybody comes from a different place. So we have people from China and Taiwan, France, Russia, Germany, Israel. Pretty recently we went kayaking. Everybody, including people who'd never set foot in a kayak, got in these kayaks and we sort of paddled around for a few hours. Once you have the experience of seeing someone who's afflicted by whatever disease you're studying, or whatever, in my case, virus you're studying, you gain a lot more appreciation for what's needed in the field. The big reasons to continue to support basic science are, one, that there's this natural inclination to want to discover. That's something that makes us human. And then, two, a lot of times these things end up leading to what we often think of as the worthwhile discoveries in health and medicine. Successful, even ultra-successful scientists fail as much as, you know, the unsuccessful scientists. It's any sort of experiment that yields a negative result, that means just as much, if not more, than an experiment that yields a positive result. And you learn from that, you build your skill set and your repertoire, and hopefully you end up with a great discovery. You know, if I, for some reason, decided, you know, I'm just not gonna come in for a week, the experiments that I was going to do wouldn't get done without me. So I think that's really an empowering feeling, to know that this is something that you're caring for. Whatever you find, whether you want to be an artist or a painter or a musician or a scientist, make sure that it's something that you really love to do, because you're going to be spending many, many years doing it as a career, so you might as well not hate it. There are so few, if any, other careers that basically, at least if you go into academia, allow you to say, here are some things I'm curious about, now I'm going to go out and seek out answers to my questions. That's such an invigorating thought.